and weary, but I must toil on till the Lord comes to call me away, where the morning is bright and the Lamb is the light and the night is as fair as the day.
Faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother Chester for burial. Let us pray with confidence to God, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. Deliver your servant Chester, O sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And let us also pray for those who mourn, that they may cast their care on God and know the consolation of God's love. Almighty God, look with pity upon the sorrows of your servants for whom we pray. Remember them, Lord, in mercy. Nourish them with patience. Comfort them with a sense of your goodness. Lift up your countenance upon them and give them peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now we continue with the opening sentences. I am resurrection and I am life, says the Lord. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die. And everyone who has life and has committed himself to me in faith shall not die forever. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awakening, he will raise me up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him, who is my friend and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we are alive in the Lord, and if we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possession. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. And now all are invited to join together in Amazing Grace.
Amazing Grace.
Was thy God now?
thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and to love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are united with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, deal graciously with the family of Chester in their grief, remembering Vivien. Surround them with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Now we'll have a reading from Ecclesiastes.
Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to another. Before the mountains were brought forth, or the land and the earth were born, from age to age you are God. You turn us back to the dust and say, go back, O child of earth. For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past. And like a watch in the night, you sweep us away like a dream. We fade away suddenly like the grass. In the morning, it is green and flourishes. In the evening, it is dried up and withered. For we consume away in your displeasure. We are afraid because of your wrathfulness indignation. Our iniquities you have set before you, and our secret sins in the light of your countenance. When you are angry, all our days are gone. We bring our years to an end like a sigh. The span of our life is 70 years, perhaps in strength even 80, yet the sum of them is but labor and sorrow, for they pass away quickly and we are gone. Who regards the power of your wrath? Who rightly fears your indignation? So teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts to wisdom. Amen.
Now we'll have a remembrance from Mr. Oliver A. Samuels.
My name is Oliver Samuels, an ancient student of Rosebank Primary School, of which the deceased was a principal. I'd like to use this opportunity of expressing my sincerest condolences to his family. Now, I do not know the difference between a eulogy and a remembrance, but from all appearances, what I am going to do here is to speak about the achievements of the gentleman and also a little of the memory that I have from the experience that I have had with him. Here we go. Born Winchester Jeremiah Williams in Monique, St. Anne on March 24, 1924, to parents Jane Lawrence Williams and Justus Augustus Williams. His siblings were Ines Leonard Melvin, John Benjamin Isaiah, and Winchester was the youngest. All of the siblings preceded him in death. He was blessed with one daughter, Jean Williams Garroway, and a son-in-law, Mervyn Garroway. Grandchildren, Zelaysia Williams, I hope the pronunciation is correct, Cassana Garroway, and Bryson Garroway. A great-great-grandson, Andrew Samuels, son of Zesha Williams. Now, he started his education at Watsonville Primary in Monique. Then he went on to Monique College, then to Michael Teachers College, where he graduated, getting a Teachers College certificate. Years after, I would imagine, he went on to the university for higher studies and got a Bachelor of Science in Education degree. Years after, he gained his master's degree in science, and I think it's science in education, in New York. He was affiliated to the JCs and the Kiwanis clubs in St. Mary, Jamaica. Also to the Ancient Order of Foresters, a British lodge organization. He was the past chief ranger in Jamaica in the late 60s. Also a past student, a member of the Mica Past Students Association in Jamaica and in New York. Monique Anglican, a member of the Monique Anglican Church, named Christ Church at the time. A member of the St. Augustine Episcopal Church in Brooklyn, New York. And there at the church, he became chaplain of two men's ministries. At one, the Brotherhood of St. Andrew, chapter 2056-S, and two, Man in the Mirror Men's Ministry. He joined those two organizations when he became a member of the church. His first marriage was to Miss Irene Pringle on August 19, 1963. She is now deceased. His career can only be described as illustrious, and what I shall be attempting to chronologize is the role of principal, but naturally he must have been a teacher before moving up to principal, knowing our system in Jamaica. So he was first principal at Jonesville Primary, then Rosebank Primary, then Zion Hill Primary, and Richmond Junior Secondary and Secondary from 1970 until retirement in 1985. That's 15 years as principal at one organization. He got married to Vivian Chambers on December 9, 2006 in New York. In August 1992, Teacher Williams, as he was affectionately known, or Little Willie behind him. Did a default change his name from Winchester to Chester? I can't imagine why. Because having lived with Winchester for all those years, probably is the RNA that he was opposing why he changed his name. We don't know. He loved gardening as a child, and he would plant vegetables and sell them to make money to pay for his college tuition. His favorite pastime was shooting birds, and for those of us of my age and a little younger, we all know that that was one of Jamaica's pastimes for boys. I was presented with several awards as a principal at all schools for his dedicated, devoted, and committed service. On February 4, 1993, he was awarded an appreciation certificate for over 30 years of faithful service to education by the Bishop of Jamaica through the Diocese of Jamaica. On the 18th of May 2014, he was given an award by the New York chapter of the Michael Student Association for his devotion and commitment to the organization. Now, folks, that's a little history of the gentleman. Now, for me, Teacher Williams played a very pivotal role, not only in my life, but in the life of the students that he had to come in contact with. I remember him very, very vividly as a man who cares for his student and for the welfare of his students. You know, at the time that where we are from, you know, our dietary, our meals really, I want a proper meal. But Teacher Williams, in his way, started or continued and developed the school garden. It's a little farm plot. And there he planted quite a bit of vegetables so that it could be used in the kitchen to supplement our diet. It became so successful that then they had to rent somewhere else and on a lot of land and into plants and all kinds of stuff. And in us attending to them and planting them, we learned about these things, peas, carrots, lettuce, cabbage, and other kinds of stuff. Now, when it comes to the whole thing of gardening, or Teacher Williams loved the gardening because he loved beauty and he wanted us to be surrounded with things of beauty. So we would paint the stones that lined the little flowers' beds, and we would plant 10 to all flowers, a lot of Joseph's court, roses, and all kinds of stuff. Begonia and Acanthus. And he encouraged us by saying to us that we're to ensure that the gardens are kept beautiful because angels come and sit in the gardens in the evening. And another thing that I remember really very dearly about him, apart from his strict disciplinarian way, I will tell a story about that. He would defend his student to the death. I remember one day some boys came into the school to fight one of the students, and teacher run or just the man, and the boy then run like thief. And teacher chase them. Anyhow, if they catch one of them, they dog would have yam for him supper. When we talk about discipline, there was one time, one day, when teacher, all he tried, we were going back after lunch, and all he tried to get our attention somehow somebody had to say something. And teacher had us over there, we standing up over there, and he said, if you don't get 100% silence, he's not going to speak. And he couldn't get it. I said, okay, but since I am not going to get my 100% silence, I'm going to beat everybody. I mean, let me tell you something, as a man, I killed them, they were scared. Every pig in the school that they did, get one kid in a left hand and one kid in the right. Now, there was a girl in school, oh Lord, she was like an angel. We call her nurse. Nurse don't talk. And me say, you could have seen when nurse go up to teacher never didn't want to be nurse, but he had to, because he never been the whole school. And poor nurse smiled for the whole week. But he carried on his order. He says he's going to be the entire school, and that's it. It's the disciplinarian in him. So folks, I want to say to the family, do not grieve too much. We are human beings, so we will grieve. But not grieve too much. Think of the memories. Think of and the wonderful memories. Think also of the great contribution that Teacher Williams has made and the lives, the thousands of lives that he touched. The last time I saw him was at a show that Bill Hofstede, one of his students, brought him to, and when he was, he watched the show and he was so proud. You could see the glow and the joy and the pride in his face when he saw me backstage. So I am very happy that I had a great opportunity of passing through or going under the tutelage of this great Winchester Jeremiah Williams. And I just want to wish for him safe journey. May his soul find rest, and that light perpetual shines upon him.
Amen. Now we'll have a reading from the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the place to where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." And this is the time of tribute. I believe Mr. James Cisnett from the Brotherhood of St. Andrew, St. Augustine's chapter is here.
Today, we come to reminisce and pay respect to a life that could no more be worthwhile spent. His life was a blessing to all of us, especially to those who come in close contact with him. Brother Winchester Williams dedicated his life to a profession that exposed him to the most opportunities for kingdom building of God's kingdom. He would always say, "You start building sound minds from the cradle right to teenage. Otherwise, if you do otherwise, you lose them." He cared about redirecting people's lives, and insists the only way to have it right is by full surrender to Christ. Chester was a school teacher by profession. He radiated Christ's light through love. He showed his love for teaching and his career. Through his approach, approach, he gained many souls who otherwise would have easily been lost. He was a strong believer that Christ's teaching of religious studies or religious studies should never have been removed from the classroom. He believed that the core principle for development of a morally strong and decent mind in a human being evolves from reading and studying the scriptures regularly. I met Brother Williams just after we started a new ministry at St. Augustine called Man in the Mirror. By that time, he was already a member of the St. Augustine chapter of Brotherhood of St. Andrew. We'll meet often at times and engage in some deep and meaningful biblical discussions. At that time, I realized that this was no freshman I was talking to, but instead a widely read classic scholar. Brother Williams knew every book in the Bible very well. It was then both men's ministry decided to engage him in deep and meaningful Bible study programs. Both ministries would have Bible study at least once per month. And Brother Williams was a person who led us through those. Eventually, Man in Mirror would take a step further. We would sponsor annual Bible quiz competitions where we engage him as a quiz master and also the person who wrote the questions. He prepared some very sound questions, some very good questions. We at times, prior to that, we thought about going outside and investigating what company do Bible quizzes and do prepare us or books on Bible quizzes. But then we realized that we had the song and the real person with us who can do a better job. And we engaged him and he did a marvelous job. The quiz competitions where we rose to a point where it became an annual feature, an annual event, and people look forward to it. We would engage from the Sunday school right through to the seniors, and it became a very big competition. Brother Williams was appointed chaplain at St. Augustine's chapter of the Brotherhood of St. Andrew, and he stayed in that position for many years. Today, I bring you condolences to the family from the president of the Brotherhood of St. Andrew, the national president, Brother Jeff Butcher, from the Province 2, Brother Roland Flowers, and also from the Brooklyn Assembly president, Brother Wentworth Jeffers. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine on him. May he rest forever in peace. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Sisnett. And now we have on the program Mr. Milton Hanchard, college friend from Jamaica.
Thank you, Reverend. To the living and gone, to the sorrowful, I will never return. To the angry, I was cheated. But to the happy, I'm at home. And to the faithful, I have never left. I cannot speak, but I can listen. I cannot be seen, but I can be heard. So as you stand upon a shore gazing at a beautiful sea, As you look upon a flower and admire its simplicity, remember me. Remember me in your heart, your thoughts, and your memories of the times we loved, the times we cried, the times we fought, the times we laughed. For if you always think of me, I will never have gone. Reverend Father Lawrence Womack, Reverend Cecil Beckford, Dr. Isaac Brown, Chairman of the Board of St. Mary, past student of St. Mary Technical High School, Mr. Oliver Samuels, O.D., Mrs. Williams, other members of the bereaved family, including adopted son Winston, past president, past and present students of Richmond Technical High School, teachers of St. Mary, Richmond, neighboring districts, friends and well-wishers. I must convey my personal condolences to Mrs. Williams and other members of the bereaved family. And I want to let you all know that you're in my thoughts and prayers. In the same breath, I want to convey condolences on behalf of the teaching fraternity of St. Mary, and specifically convey personal condolences on behalf of my friend, past president of St. Mary Teachers Association, past president of Jamaica Teachers Association, JTA, retired acting chief education officer of the Ministry of Education, Jamaica, Rudyard K. Ellis, Dorothy Duncan Ellis, also a past student of the deceased. It was my intention to say a few words and use borrowed lines in poetry, but that would be injustice. So I'm going to crave your indulgence for a couple more minutes. Teacher Williams was a dedicated educator, deep thinker, full of wit and humor, well-liked and never afraid of challenges. He was an extraordinary human being. The discussions we had over the years were usually uplifting, profound, interesting, thought-provoking, and educational. I will mention some of the names frequently came up in our discussions. Nelson Mandela, Martin Luther King, Marcus Garvey, John Dewey, Colin Powell, Helen Keller, Noam Chomsky, and Harriet Tubman. My colleague was intolerant of ignorance, but understanding of illiteracy. And this tells you about the social consciousness of this individual. Why would we have discussion about Martin Luther King? Because they were aligned in their thoughts. Martin Luther King said, "The function of education is to teach one intensively and critically, because intelligence plus character is the true goal of education." My colleague was an extraordinary educator, inside out. My brother's thinking was deep, enjoyable, and provocative. He was never afraid to put you on the spot in a discussion, and he did it with diplomacy, wit, and charm. He once gave me his usual trademark smile And said Milton, Mandela said, courage is not the absence of fear, but triumph over it. Because the brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he who conquers that fear. Then the question came, do you think Mandela's experiences provoked these utterances? And then we had to go into a discussion, as you will know. I can recall an experience as if it were yesterday. We were in a group discussion, and someone said, where there is no vision, the people perish. My quick-witted brother was quick to the draw, and he quipped, well, let us clear up the difference between sight and vision. Because Helen Keller said, the only thing worse than being blind is having sight and no vision. In prosperity, our friends know us, but in adversity, we know who are our friends. To the family, as you go through the grieving process, be reminded that death is not the end. Death is never the end. Death is only the road. Life is the traveler, and the soul is the guide. Our minds think of death. Our hearts think of life. And our souls think immortality. Be assured that the Heavenly Father will protect you all with the limitless span of his wings. In closing, I salute my brother, Pass My Conian, with borrowed lines from the poet Rudyard Kipling. I chose these lines because they were written by Kipling as if he were speaking to his son. He wanted the son to know and have the information that if they are to have their place in society, they would have to live with integrity and dignity. So here the late Chester Williams speaks to you in death as he lived and spoke to you in life. If you can dream and not make dreams your master, if you can think and not make thoughts your aim, if you can meet with triumph and disaster and treat these two impostures just the same, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too. If you can make one heap of all your winnings and risk it on one turn of pitch and toss and lose and start again at your beginnings and never breathe a word about your loss. If you can talk with kings and not lose your virtue. If you can walk with kings and not lose a common touch. If neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you. If all men count with you, but none too much. If you can hold on when there's nothing in you except the will which says, hold on. If you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours the earth and everything that's in it. And which is more, will be a man. My son, may his soul rest in peace.
Thank you.
And may life everlasting shine upon it.
Friends, members of the clergy, It's given me great pleasure to stand before you to talk about Teacher Williams just for a little while. Amen? This man, we call him Teacher. He's been in my life since I was about 8 and a half, 9 years old, when he came to Rosebank School in St. Mary. But my friend, I just want to let you know, in this life journey, there's three things we have to take with us to carry us through. Love somebody, and somebody love you back. And when you die, where are you going? Okay. Amen? Love is the greatest, one of the greatest scripture in the Bible. Amen? And the Bible goes on to let you know you got to let your election calling be sure. Amen? If your election calling be sure, you know where you are going when you die. Amen? And when you love somebody, that somebody loves you back. Amen? That is a part of the life. Amen? This man, Winchester, Jeremiah Williams, is one of the greatest human beings I ever come across in my lifetime. He's a people's person. He loves people. My friend, from the hills of St. Anne, where he from? He take love with him. Amen? Right into Money College. Educate himself. University. He take love with him. In St. Mary, he told me that he used to teach at Linster. Amen? Job's Hill. Then he came to Rosebank School. He bring the love, that everlasting love with him. Love people. He loved children. Amen? I remember him. One time I was talking in the class and he said to me, he called me son, and he called out my name. He said, Cecil Roy Beckford, don't waste your time in youth. Amen. That goes in my head. Amen. And I keep that as memory. I've seen him all through the years at my mother's wedding. He was the best man. That time I was wearing short pants. Praise God. Amen. But that man, he has a special love for me. As a student, of one of his students. Praise God. And everywhere I go, and I come in contact with him, that love was still there. Even at his wedding, he called me up and he said, I'm not leaving you out. I want you to be a part of this. Be one of the ministers to do something at my wedding. Praise God. Amen. That's how close me and him is. We're very close. Amen? But The blessed assurance. I'm so glad today that I don't come to a funeral service. I'm here to celebrate a going home service. Amen? Because teacher make his election call and be sure. He know Christ as his personal savior. Amen? Solomon was writing in Proverbs 2 and 27. He said, my friend, when you lay down, don't be afraid, lay down. Because your sleep will be sweet. Amen? Praise God. Today, teach us sleep sweet. Amen? Because the Bible says, my friend, if you sleep in Jesus, God will bring you with him. Amen? Praise God. The Bible goes on to let you know, it said, blessed is the dead who die in the Lord. Henceforth, they rest from their labor. Amen? Praise God. I believe on the 3rd of July, when teacher lay down, he wasn't afraid of death. He wasn't afraid of death. Because he know that if he sleep in Jesus, his sleep will be sweet. Amen? Amen? Yes. Teach us sleep sweet. Amen. But today I just want to say to you, teacher make his election call and be sure.
Yes.
Amen. He know that when he die, he know where he is going.
Yeah.
Amen. The Bible said to absent from this life is to be in present with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Yes. Amen. Praise God. So I just want to say, my brother, sleep on. Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon your Savior's breast. We love you, my brother, but Jesus loves you best. Sleep sweet, my brother. Sleep sweet. Sleep on. I'll see you in the morning. I'll meet you over there.
Today I'd like to pay tribute to our former principal, Mr. Winchester J. Williams, who has been a tour of strength to all of us. I therefore represent the Past Student Association, especially those of us who were there while he was principal. In paying tribute to this very great man, it begs the question, who was this man? This man was indeed a father to all of us who went to that institution for the very first time, as he facilitated our integration into the institution. He provided direction. He helped us, so he caused us to blend into that new environment with consummate ease. Who was this man? This man was a teacher of no mean order. He was logical in his presentation whenever he had to deal with us. Whenever he was through with you, it was easy for you to remember all the things that he had said. Who was this man? This man was a fantastic leader. He led from the front. What I'm saying is that he himself was an example. So he did those things that he wanted those persons he was leading to do. Who was this man? He was humorous. And so we had much laughter at devotion on numerous occasions. We remember him for that. I pay tribute to a man was indeed a very great manager. He managed the human resources, the financial resources, and material resources at that institution effectively and efficiently. Who was this man? This man was very caring. He was caring to all of us. He was caring to teachers, ancillary staff, students, stakeholders, all those who came in contact with him, he demonstrated that he was indeed a caring individual. Who was this man? He wore a very unique hairstyle, that thick afro in those days. And he always go around with a small comb in his breast pocket. And you'd see him combing his hair many times per day as he took pride in that afro hairstyle. In our own way, we called him Willie Boy quietly because we could not have said that in front of him. Today, we'd like to pay our last respect to him, recognizing this powerful individual. He has fought a good fight. He has kept the faith, and we believe with all our heart that there's little for him, the crown of righteousness. Well done, Winchester J. Williams. Well done, Willie Boy. We appreciate all that you did for us. You will continue to make sure that your legacy lives on. To the family, we express sympathy. Be strong. Be courageous. The Lord Jesus will give you the strength to endure at such a time as this. May his soul rest in peace.
I am Claudette Morris, president of the Michael University College Alumni Association, New York chapter, expressing condolences on behalf of the association. The president of the headquarters of the Michael University College Alumni Association in Kingston, Jamaica, Dr. Merritt Henry, has conveyed condolences on behalf of the members in Jamaica and the diaspora. She offers prayers to comfort you in this time of bereavement and hope that you will feel uplifted by the work of Mr. Williams, as evidenced by his indelible footprint in the education sector. I'm sure Mr. Williams would be very proud to see how his students have turned out to honor him and to show love and support to his family. Chester, as he was affectionately called, hails from the Garland Parish of St. Anne, where he began his early education at the Watsonville Elementary School. Chester, in his goal of making education a right and not a privilege, enrolled at this prestigious Michael College for his teacher training education. In this environment, Chester was surrounded by a wealth of knowledge from both instructors and students. Within this network, he was able to identify the elementary sector as where he wanted to make an impact. Mr. Williams, on completing his teacher education at the Michael Teachers College in Kingston, began his journey home to St. Anne. Traveling through the junction, taking him through St. Mary. Fortunately for the students in St. Mary, Mr. Williams decided to make the parish of St. Mary his stop. He would perform different roles from classroom teacher to the role of principal. Because of his tenacity and the talents of his students, these schools gained prominence in the Spelling Bee Championship and successful scholarship awards. He would later culminate his remarkable teaching career in Jamaica at the Richmond Secondary School after a memorable tenure in which he saw attendance doubling in the first 2 years under his leadership. Mr. Williams, having earned a bachelor's degree in education at the University of the West Indies, also served as branch president of the Jamaica Teachers Association and supervisor for teachers on internship in the parishes of St. Mary and Portland. He was a president of the Kiwanis Club in St. Mary, lay preacher and Eucharist minister in the Anglican Church, receiving special recognition from the Bishop of Jamaica. In listening to the aforementioned achievements, you should be in no doubt that Mr. Williams was a true Michaelian. He personified the Michael motto, do it with thy might. Again, it should be of no surprise that having completed this great service to the education sector in Jamaica and hanging up his gloves, so to speak, he would migrate to the United States and complete a Master of Science degree from Brooklyn College and Master's degree in Special Education from the Touro College. Mr. Williams brought enrichment to the Michael University College Alumni Association in New York through his knowledge and experiences. The association honored him in 2014 for his contribution to education and for his outstanding membership and generosity of service. He was an exceptional preacher. And so we would not worry about who would deliver the word when we had our special commemorative Michael Church services. Let us not forget that Chester could also give a spirited musical rendition. His soft but strong voice would, as they say, be music to your ears. The education and the church communities appreciate his vision, his guidance, and his faithfulness. The spirituality that he was able to nurture ensured that the communities remained strong. In 2 Timothy chapter 1, he says, "For this reason, I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God, which is in you through the laying on of my hands." The scripture goes on to say, God has called us to a holy calling, not because of our works, but because of his own purpose and grace, which he gave us in Christ Jesus. As a Myconian, the expectation is that you walk in your purpose. Help your fellow man, be passionate, and leave this world better than you saw it, and do it with your might. Brother Chester Williams did this every day. May his soul rest in peace.
That this is not simply a time to rehearse a life, although that is appropriate. That it is not simply a time to gather together, but it is a time to be reminded and to celebrate not just a life lived extraordinarily, but a life lived with the promises of eternal life. A life lived in such a way that any and all who came in contact with him knew whose he was, and that he thought it important, maybe even his most important work, to share that gospel with them. The stories that you have heard, these accomplishments, the things that you know personally from your experiences with him are the testimony of his life. You know them very well. You have told them and probably will tell them again and again and again. But be reminded, friends, that everything that he accomplished, his soft yet strong way, his bright and enduring smile, the way that he gently led you into conversation, all are because of the grace of God in which he dwelled. The grace of God that he carried with him in each and every encounter. You know, we know people that do things a certain way in one place and a different way in another. Folks that speak a certain way when they're in one crowd and a different way in another. Such that if we had seen them in each, we would wonder which one was the real one. Not the case with Winchester, as I've learned today. Jeremiah Williams. Consistent across the board with whoever, whenever, however you came across him, you knew who he was and whose he was. You know, he's one of those folks that really didn't even have to say a word. Didn't have to open his mouth. For he carried himself with the Spirit of the living God. The kind of person that would walk by and be like, I wonder who that is. And people in maybe even in hushed tones would say, oh, that's Mr. Williams. You might want to get to know him. See, friends, today is a reminder, and it's not often. I mean, it happens, but it's not often that the life that is being celebrated follows so closely with the gospel. Because my job here is not to rehearse the stories, even though I have my own. My job here is to make the connection for us that are now yet living to how we can live our lives in as full a way as possible, sharing the gospel in the way that he shared it. See, there's a funny thing about our faith. We have these folks that are around us called saints. And most of the time they're ancient people, and we have a few shining lights, but so often, friends, saints are the everyday folk that we know. They live up the block, that were our principals, our teachers, our grandparents, our friends. And if you would permit me to cast this picture, that maybe, just maybe, Chester Williams has been our saint.
Amen.
And maybe, just maybe, as we celebrate his life today, we'll give thanks to God.
Amen.
We'll even celebrate for having known him.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe, just maybe, this time together today, though sorrowful, will help us to be better than we thought we could be as we follow our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because maybe our reminder this day, maybe these times of grief that pull at us, that drain us even to the point of maybe being tempted to have despair, are those times when then we can hear the Spirit speaking most clearly. That we hear Jesus' voice echoed in the gospel today, that I have already gone to prepare a place for you. If I hadn't done it, would I have told you? That we can rest assured, solid, and steadfast that the love of God is so powerful that even death can't stop it. You all know he knew that. You all know that his life was informed with that reality. You all know that in his debates and his teaching and his leadership and his chaplaincy and his Bible study and all of those things, that deep within him was the knowledge that his soul was secure. Even if we serve legions of people, everybody knows our name, people speak well of us. Even if we have success beyond our wildest imagining, if it doesn't have love as its base, it is really for naught, friends. So if you haven't heard anything, if you haven't heard anything that's said through the readings or the testimonies, the tributes, the hymns that we have sung, the scripture that has been read, remember your call to love.
Amen.
And when we do that, we are doing what Jesus came to give us to do. Because in our salvation is the love of God, and in the love of God is our salvation. So make very sure today, friends, that whatever you come across, whatever the challenges are that you might face, the heaviness of your heart, the questions that might surface and cause anxiety in your mind and even in your body, remember that God's love is the most powerful thing in the universe. And if that doesn't make it click for you, remember Chester Williams and his love. And that through that love, maybe we'll be able to see and understand and fully feel the love of God. And then we'll be changed and transformed and able to do a greater work, even the work as powerful as Jesus the Christ, showing forth God's love in the world and resting in the assurance that Jesus has already made a place for us. And in that reality, we can live with bold confidence and blessed assurance that the love of God is ours and that we are secure in that salvation. Amen. And now, friends, you can keep your seats as we move forward through the prayers of the people that is found on page 7 of our service bulletin. And during these prayers, your response is, "Hear us, Lord." For our brother Chester, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "I am resurrection and I am life." Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Chester, and dry the tears of those who weep. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. Hear us, Lord. You raised the dead to life. Give to our brother eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our brother to the joys of heaven. Our brother was washed in baptism and anointed by the Holy Spirit. Give him fellowship with all your saints. He was nourished with your body and blood. Grant him a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our brother. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. And now let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to you our brother, who was reborn by water and the Spirit in holy baptism. Grant that his death may recall to us your victory over death and be an occasion for us to renew our trust in your Father's love. Give us, we pray, the faith to follow where you have led the way and where you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit to the ages of ages. Amen. And friends, you're invited to stand as we join together in the hymn, "Blessed Assurance." take a couple of moments for any additional tributes. We'll ask that you will keep those to 2 minutes. Before we do that, to Miss Vivian Williams, we express our condolences from St. Augustine's and know that as you have need, please do not hesitate to call on us. We give thanks to the clergy that are here, Reverend Beckford, Reverend Clark, who needed to leave. We give thanks for Mrs. Monica Turnbull Clark, who helped to put this together, and also Mrs. Pringle Campbell, who's been very helpful in getting this service together.
And I want to take this time again to offer my deepest sincere condolences to the family. I didn't know our dear, you know, Mr. Chester, amen, but I got to know Mr. Grant, amen. I want to thank you for, you know, extend the invitation to us to be here on today. But the writer said, may the life I live speaks for me. May the company that I keep speak for me. The work that I've done, it may seem so small, and sometimes it may seem like nothing at all. But we're confident when we come to the end of life journey, we will hear the good master said, well done. And in this life that we're living in, we do a lot of work for people, work for ourselves. But it is only what we've done for Christ we're lost. And I want to also encourage every one of us today, let us LIP. So when with D-I-E, we can R-I-P. Let us live in peace. So when we died, we can rest in peace. Because most of the time, when someone died, living in a war, they put a big sign, rest in peace. But they weren't living in peace. They were fighting, hating, devouring one another, hating, and died in the battle of war. But then, when they died, they said, rest in peace. I don't know how that's going to be, but living for Jesus, He give us that peace that passes all understanding. So may God continue to bless you and keep you. And in the midst of the corona, just remember that God got it all in control. God bless you. Be strong and be of good courage. Amen.
Mr. Sisnett, that double jeopardy you spoke about, it was really and truly a learning experience for me with egg on my face. I remember the question was asked, where is Easter mentioned in the Bible? And of course, I thought this Bible scholar knows what you're talking about. So I said, no place. Easter is not mentioned, no place. And my brother Chester looked at me and he shook his head. He said, yes, it's in the Bible. I said, no, it's not in the Bible. Yes, show it to me. And of course, he went to Acts and found Easter in the Bible. Imagine the student challenging the teacher, of all teachers, learned my lesson with Chester. Even though I'm sure of an answer, I never would open my mouth and say anything again. do you remember that, Mr. Sisnett? That was the day and that was learning. My name is Leandra V. Batiste Lambert, and I'm standing here on behalf of my family. We had a relationship with Chester that was out of this world. My children were very, very small when our path crossed. And it turned out to be a divine, everlasting encounter. I did not have the opportunity to sit in a classroom in Jamaica, but I sat in the classroom at St. Augustine's Church, at the hospitals, at the nursing homes, on the bench across the street, driving down the block. Chester is walking, I pick him up and we parked outside his house, classrooms, classroom is restaurant. Those were real institution of learning for me and my children. When I broke the news to my children, one of them said, "Here goes the last of the Mohegan." Another one says, "Oh my goodness, just the man Ora tells you that he is God himself." My daughter, whose life was impacted greatly by Chester, with his devotion, his knowledge of God, his sincerity, his love of God and everything. Chester had a lot to do with her, where she is now in her vocation. She's now an Episcopal priest in the Diocese of Long Island. And I would say 99.99% is because of the interaction she had with Chester. There's another child who I couldn't reach, but I know he too is pleased of having known Chester. And I can boldly stand here and say that Chester is my grandfather, my father, my husband, my boyfriend, my lover, my man, my brother, my son, my cousin, my uncle, my nephew. He's all these things to me. Okay, having said that, for all the saints who from the labor rest, there lies Chester. And Chester, please know that Abraham, Isaac, Ishmael, and Jacob salutes you. Yes, Ishmael. Although Ishmael was an outcast, Chester embraced everyone, so Ishmael has to be included in this recognition. Sarah, Hagar, yes. Rebecca, Rachel, and Leah salutes you. Deborah, Ruel, Esther, the major and minor prophets salute you. And how fitting for me to find out today that your name is Jeremiah. Oh, God doesn't make any mistake. Boaz, Naomi, and Ruth salutes you. Cranmer, Latimer, and Ridley salutes you. Peter is standing on the Mount of Transfiguration, and Peter says, "Hold it. Don't build any tower, stop building any tabernacle yet. We have to build four instead of..." Thank you. Peter is standing there at the Mount of Transfiguration and saying, "We now have to build four tabernacles instead of three. One for Elijah, one for Moses, one for Jesus, and definitely one for Chester." Peter is very happy to welcome you in the company with James and John Chester, because he knows that if anyone can shed light of what's going on, if anyone can explain God and the purpose and everything, you can do it. So he welcomes you, and he's promised to stay quiet, not rush to answer anything. Paul, Timothy, Barnabas, and Silas welcome you on the journey as they preach the word. They all stood back in awe and put you in the forefront because they know no one can do it as well as you can, Chester. Martin, Malcolm, and Medgar stand tall side by side with you, listening to you, paying attention, and gathering strategies how to move on. John the Baptist and even Doubting Thomas welcomes you. Shaking their head, they said, "This is a man of all men. What a godly man." Pauli Murray, Absalom Jones, Richard B. Martin, Horace Walker, Oscar Romero, and Barbara Harris all salute you because you're a teacher and you've been teaching them all their lives. Jackie Robinson, Ann Karen, Paul Robeson, Adam Clayton Powell, Frederick Douglass, they all salute you. Reverend Vivian, Elijah Cummings, John Lewis, Shirley Chisholm, all stand to pay respect to the man of all men. Jim Reeves, Bob Marley, Peter Tosh, Jimmy Cliff, Hopton Lewis, Joseph Miles, they all salute you. Mary, Jesus' mother, Mary Magdalene, Salome, Veronica, they all pay the respect and salute you. Even Judas, Pilate, Herod, the crowd that said, crucify, crucify, stood back and listened when you opened your mouth, and they were just in awe when you spoke. James Baldwin, Booker T. Washington, W.E.B. Du Bois, Toni Morrison, and Maya Angelou salutes you and welcome you. Sammy Davis, Miss Lou, Nipsey Russell, they all pay enough respect to you. Sojourner Truth, Harriet Tubman, Rosa Parks, the woman at the well, and the woman with the issue of blood is still in wonderment as to your knowledge, the wealth of your knowledge, and your godliness. Eric Williams, Errol Barrow, Eric Gary, Maurice Bishop, Sebastamanti, Siaga, John Crumpton, Eugenia Charles, Lester Bird, Mandley, and Chetty Jagan, they all look to you and thank you for your contribution. Nelson Mandela, Walter Sisulu, Oliver Tambo, Stephen Becker, Antonio Lamberi, Kwame Nkrumah, all salute you. Mama Winnie Mandela, Adelaide Otambo, and Albertina Sisulu stand with their husbands to pay you respect. Gandhi, Toussaint Louverture, Marcus Messiah Garvey, Mother Teresa salutes you. Amen. The Brotherhood of St. Andrew, St. Andrew is standing on the seashore with his brother and the rest of the disciples waiting for you because Chester, I stand here in full confidence that you are the Brotherhood all by yourself. And so I'm happy that you joined the band of Milton Abbott, Gerald Moses, Kenneth Noel, Ronald Rookwood, Victor Dixon, Hamilton Simpson, Ivan O'Blake, Wilkinson, Cecil Robinson, Neil, Keith Anderson, Mr. Nichols, Clementina Robinson, and Stephanie Boswini from the Brotherhood of St. Augustine's Prayer Group is St. Augustine Prayer Group, your friend Loretta Ward, Yvonne Springer, Etime Scott, Alicia Edwin, Edith Williams, salutes you. And finally, as I close, we know Chester was not limited by time. Finally, as I close, I say this. The prestigious learning institution all confer the honorary doctorate degrees in all aspects of life and humanity to Chester Jeremiah Williams. If not the greatest, one of the greatest, greatest educator, intellectual minds. University of the West Indies, Cave Hill in Barbados, St. Augustine in Trinidad, Mona Campus in Jamaica, Oxford, Cambridge, Yale, Harvard, Cornell, Princeton, Stanford, Brown, Columbia, McGill University, all stand and says, Welcome home, thou good and faithful servant. Come home to rest. Your work here is completed. On earth is completed. My brother Chester, may you rest in peace and rise again in glory. You have gave me so much, so much, so much. I'm the better person because of knowing you.
I know him as teacher. He taught me in school, Rosebank School. Then he went to Richmond when I went to England. And I met him back in New York, and he's been like a father to me. I remember he used to preach in the Presbyterian Church at Rosebank School. And I remember him, and when I met him back in New York, we were close again. And God bless his soul. He's a very good man, and his past students, all of us here, this place would be full because he has taught us discipline, respect, and they would all. Coronavirus has taken his friends and his students away from him, but we're still with him.
And continuing with the commendation on page 9 of our service bulletin. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sign but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Give rest, O Christ. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Chester. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Amen. Lord, now lettest thou thy servant depart in peace, according to thy word.
For my eyes have seen thy salvation, which thou hast prepared before the face of all people, to be a light to lighten the Gentiles, and to be the glory of thy people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
And now, friends, the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in God's sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be on you and remain with you, both this day and even forevermore. Amen. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, a pleasant good day to you all in this my moments of grief. To many of us, God has a plan for each and every one of us. And those we love, he takes the young, he takes the old. He has taken my husband from me. But I'm grateful to Almighty God, because I know where I'm going, I know where he's going, I know he has gone. Mm-hmm. And I'm looking forward to that day that I will be that happy jubilation, the happy jubilation that we all will be facing on that day. So I'm asking everybody that are present here today, let us give our lives in totality to Christ. That we'll all see who we are looking forward to be seeing on that day. And I'm thanking you all for having been here with us today to share with our, you know, in our grief. God is good all the time. And not sometime, but all the time. So God bless you all, and to our pastor here, God bless you, sir. And thank you for all that you have done. Thank you, Spirit.
Everyone the Father gives me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother Winchester, and we commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious unto him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and give him everlasting peace. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May his soul and the souls of all the departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. For alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Thanks be to God. And now the God of peace, brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in God's sight. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be on you and remain with you for this day and even forevermore. Amen.